Hi everybody, it's Sammy Banting, the Operations Director with the Hanley Homes Group, and I am joined today by one of our strategic partners that we have here. This is Brice Ferguson with Supreme Lending, and today he's going to talk to us a little bit about the first-time home buying process. So, Brice, why don't you tell us who you are and what you do?
Sure. All right, so I'm a mortgage lender with a company called Supreme Lending. We operate in all 50 states throughout the union, and we basically help people figure out how to go from wanting to own a home to owning a home and arranging the financing that goes along with that. We help everybody from first-time home buyers to last-time home buyers and everything in between. There's not a specific customer that is our strict focus. We want to help as many families as possible get into safe and secure home ownership. Personally, I've been in the mortgage lending world for about 4.5 years. Prior to that, I have about 10 years experience in personal finance and consumer finance in the banking industry. So going on 15 years in total. Love what I do. There's no more satisfying feeling than sitting down with a family at the closing table and knowing that because of the hard work of you, your team, and the real estate teams that were involved, these people now own a home.
That's exciting. It's one of we love working with first-time home buyers, people who didn't know that they could buy a home, and then we put them in contact with people like Brice, and he kind of talks them through the process and sees, like, if you can rent, a lot of times you can also own your own home.
Very, very true. So many people don't know that they are ready today to own a home. They've gotten scared. They've heard all these bad, funny things. They've gone and talked to somebody a while back who kind of put them off the whole process. And the fact of the matter is, there are so many different loan programs out there today to accommodate so many different families that if you're not up to speed on the conversation, you may assume that you've got to continue to pay these astronomical rent prices when really you can be owning the same home for hundreds of dollars less every month.
That's something that we are really want people to know is if you can rent, most of the time, a lot of times, talking to a professional can show you that you can also buy. So say let's give a little scenario. I'm a first-time home buyer. I've never bought a house before. I'm a little confused. I've talked to the Hanley Homes Group because I know that I need a good realtor on my side. So I've got my whole team from the Hanley Homes Group with me. And then I go, what do I do next? We get the contact information for one of our awesome lenders, Brice, and I call you and I go, what do I do now?
So the very first thing that we need to do is establish what goal are you trying to set. Now, you mentioned that this is your first time purchasing a home. It's a daunting experience. I've been there personally, but we want to drill down. Is this a home just for yourself? Is it for your family? Is it you and another? What are we looking at here? What's our big picture? Are you guys looking at a condo? Are you looking at a single family residence? Are we talking a mobile home out on some acreage? What's the vision? And we want to establish what that is. Once we know what we're trying to solve, what the goal is we're trying to meet, then we start looking at the actual financials. And we look at four main things. We look at your credit, and I hate to say that somebody isn't just a number, but when it comes to your credit, the score is very important. But we don't just look at the score, we look at trends and those sorts of things. We look at your income, and for some people, income is very straightforward. Salaried employees, W-2 employees, people that have a long, consistent job history of making the same amount of money, that's easy to calculate. What we find these days, especially with the change of how employment has become in the United States, that not everybody is strictly 40 hours. A lot of people are part-time. A lot of people have been kicked over to 1099. We do have a spirit of entrepreneurism, so there's a lot of people that own their own small business, that it can become very difficult to just say, oh, well, I make this much money. So we kind of want to go through the nitty-gritty on that. And then we take a look at your assets. Even if you're doing low-down payment, or these days we have 100% financing available for a lot of different first-time home buyers, there's still going to be costs associated with a loan, what we call closing costs. That's things like your taxes, your insurance, your lender fees, your title fees, those sorts of things that are still going to have to be paid, whether it's by the buyer or by the seller, depending upon what the circumstances of the loan program allows. So we look at those three things, credit, income, and cash. And then the fourth key thing is usually what we talk about first, oddly enough, is the property type itself. Certain loan programs are available for, say, a condominium that are more viable, such as conventional financing, whereas something along the lines of FHA or VA financing may be non-viable or not even possible, depending upon the actual property itself. So we have this full, complete conversation, and we start gathering documentation to support what we've discussed. The idea that we want to do is eventually get to the point where we issue what's known as a pre-approval letter. And that pre-approval means that we've gone through the documentation, we've reviewed credit, and we know that based on what we're looking at here, with all the information that we have, it is a viable loan process. That way, when you're out negotiating with a seller, you can say, okay, I've got these clients, they're pre-approved, let's go ahead and get this started, here's what they can offer, and it helps with the price negotiation as well.
That's awesome. So we have four things to look at. Credit.
Credit. Income.
Income. Your property type.
And your cash assets.
Your cash assets. So four things. And what's great is I made that phone call and I'm still confused. And Brice sends me a lovely introduction email, lets me know exactly what I need to send him, broken down for me. I get him all the information and then we get a pre-approval letter. And that pre-approval letter, just so you know as a buyer, is your ticket to open, to go check out houses. If you don't have that pre-approval letter, a lot of times agents don't really want to bother because you're kind of a looky-loo in a sense. But we also want to make sure we're not looking at a house that's way out of the spectrum of what you can afford. So that's why you have these conversations with Brice or people like Brice so that we can show you houses that really fit what kind of market that you can definitely be viable in.
One of the biggest mistakes that I find that people make is they go out and they go online and they type into their favorite search engine, hey, I'm looking for a new home, and they get sent to Zillow or Trulia or Realtor.com. They haven't consulted with a realtor to understand the process, but oh my goodness, they start looking at all these beautiful houses and they look up statistics for their median price range, all this stuff, and they get so excited, but they don't know how much they can afford. Once you become emotionally attached to a $350,000 home, if you then go and find out you can afford a $175,000 home, it's going to taint the buying experience. So we always try to get people to understand what they can afford before they put any emotional investment into the home buying process. Now, that's that's a way easier said than done. People are people, and everybody gets curious at 11 o'clock at night when they're sitting on their phone or in front of their computer, and they want to see what's out there. So I totally get that. But at all possible, we want people to have an understanding of what's realistic as opposed to just, hey, this house is beautiful and it's what I want to own. Now, I do work with a lot of clients that aren't ready to buy today. And for them, our goal conversation is this is where we want to get to. And for some people, it's 90 days. For some people, it's 2 years. But we want to make sure that they, when the timing is right to strike the hammer, they are ready to go. So we build an actual plan. This is the money you need to set aside. This is what can be done to repair credit if that's an issue, to get them there. So it's a process for some folks. Some folks are not ready today, but many are, and they don't even know it.
So what I'm hearing is if you think that you're ready to buy or you're not quite sure, the best thing to do right now is to contact a lender and really see what your buying power is.
Absolutely.
So Brice, how can people contact you?
Best way to get a hold of me, whether it's via phone or via text, is via my phone number, and that's 941-735-9304. Of course, the second best option would be via email, and that's Brice, B-R-I-C-E, .Ferguson, F-E-R-G-U-S-O-N, at supremelending.com. And I check that email address nearly 24 hours a day. And you can get a hold of me via phone or via text at your convenience. One of the things that's very real about our world these days is most of the families we serve, especially first-time homebuyers, are working 9 to 5. They can't take time off from work to come into my office and meet for an hour and a half. So we work remotely, we work digitally around their scheduled times that works for their family to make sure that this process is as convenient as possible.
And what's great too is I will leave his information in the comment section below so that if you want to get a hold of him, you can, or you can always send us a message, send through Facebook, or I'll leave our contact information as well so that we can get in contact with you so we can set you up for your pre-approval and then find you the home of your dreams at this point. Perfect. Brice, it was so great to talk to you, and I hope that we can bring you back again and we can talk about some of the nitty-gritties of things like credit.
Absolutely. I can spend 20 minutes on each of those four things. So anytime you guys want to have me on, I'd be more than happy to do it.
Awesome. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for watching. And if you have any questions, leave us a comment, send us a message, or give us a call, and we'd be happy to help you. Bye, everybody.
Take care, guys.